please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Amit Agarwal, the CFO, Jet Airways, has joined us. Good morning, Mr. Agarwal, and thank you very much for joining us. Looking at your Q1 numbers, it's an underperformance vis-a-vis your peers. What really is the drag?
If you look at it, Jet Airways has been fundamentally focused both on the domestic and the international markets. And we have seen that the domestic markets continue to improve. And whereas in the international market, especially the Gulf market, where we have witnessed a challenge, both in terms of the numbers of travelers, that is passenger numbers, and the yields, which is the fares, have been subdued. However, our focus has been on the primary growth into the domestic market and the long haul in the international markets, especially moving our gateway from Brussels into Amsterdam. That has already supported the business and would continue to focus. And based on that, we have increased our flights from Bangalore, Amsterdam, Chennai, Paris, and third frequency from Bombay, London.
Okay, Amit, so what are you expecting from the international market? I mean, will this pressure recede? By when can we expect so?
So if you look at it, our focus has been clearly on the CASK, that is cost available per available seat kilometer, excluding fuel, which has been consistently going down. And we have demonstrated that very, very clearly in this quarter as well. And the other focus, if you see, is clearly on growth and network opportunities, and that has also led to improvement. On the other hand, if you look at the debt reduction, our focus continues to be on that. And over the last two and a half years, we have been able to reduce the debt by more than 2,800 crores in the company. So that continues to be our focus, and that is being demonstrated.
Okay, Amit, good morning. Your last quarter EBITDA margins were below 13%. By when do we expect operational performance to stabilize?
Okay, as I mentioned to you, the Gulf market weakness was there, where the ability to pass on the fuel increases, which you said to yourself, could not be there, and we could not pass the fuel increases to the customers in the Gulf region. And we are working hard on the aspects how to improvise on the revenue generating opportunities into the Gulf markets to stabilize further. And we expect to see these movements, but at this juncture, I'm not going to give any guidance about the next quarter's profitability.
Okay, I get that, but sort of maybe some sort of a range. Can we expect maybe 15% EBITDA margins in the current year?
No. So as I mentioned, you see, we are not going to discuss about the guidance, but our focus is clearly in terms of reduction in the CASK. That is continuously our focus, and we'll stay there, focus.
Okay, coming to certain sort of overarching issues, is infrastructure a problem as a whole for the aviation industry?
We believe very clearly that till such time the infrastructure development or growth happens, it is very difficult to achieve that growth. Clearly, if you see today between Bombay and Delhi, you are not getting the slots. And since you are not getting the slots, these two are primary cities where the traffic originates or destinates to. So therefore, the challenge on a long-term basis would be to improve the infrastructure, and then you can see a sustainable growth. And if you see globally, the economies where the aviation growth tends to be in a developing economy, it ranges from 1.3 to 1.5x of the GDP growth. And thereby, I continue to believe that in the range of 9 to 12% would be a normal growth. And any further growth, which was possible in the past, was also on account of lower seat factors, which we all had in the past. Now you don't have that possibility anymore left, because most of the airplanes are fuller, and you are operating at a seat factor around the 84-85%.
Okay, is that the reason why the load factors have remained low at around 82% for Jet Airways?
Fundamentally, if you look at it, our aircraft utilization is gone up significantly. Before 2 years, we were in the range of 11.2, and currently we are in the range of 13.2 to 13.3 hours, which, as per the Boeing, is the highest aircraft utilization globally. So therefore, by far, we have the highest utilization of aircraft. Second thing, if you look at it, in terms of a seat factor, we have a seat factor between both economy and business class, and the seat factor, we still enjoy the same level, but we don't chase the last, absolutely the lowest yield. What we want is a quality yield, and that is why we would compromise a percent here or there in the economy in terms of the seat factor, because we do not want to be going down into the lowest of the fares.
Fair point, but what is your expectation of how yields will turn out in the current and the next quarters? Do you see any improvement?
Good growth development of yield in the last four quarters, and we continue to believe that this yields on a rational basis should be either stay at the same level or slightly move up.
Okay, your gross debt levels are still fairly high, if I could say, at around 8,700 crore rupees. So what are the plans? Are you looking at paring down something substantially this year?
If you see, as I mentioned earlier, that we are very clearly focused on two things. One, on account of a CASK reduction. Second is on a debt reduction. In the last two and a half years, we have reduced a debt by third. We are in the journey to reduce the debt, and our focus continues to remain the same. And thereby, as I mentioned always, that we will focus to reduce the debt on a consistent basis at Jet Airways.
Yeah, but can you give us any number in terms of debt reduction over the next 1 or 2 years?
I would not like to give a guidance in terms of a debt reduction. Our efforts have already been demonstrated by reducing one third of the debt, which shows very clearly that the company's ability to reduce debt is significant and has been demonstrated. And we will do it utmost to ensure that the cash flow generations of the company are only utilized for debt reduction, even to the extent that when we are taking our new MAX 737 MAX deliveries from June 18 onwards, we are going to be not taking on the balance sheet, but it is on sale and lease back model. So thereby, there is no possibility of increasing a debt on account of aircraft acquisition as well.
Okay, that should be, of course, good news for your investors. But we keep getting buzz of a stake sale. Anything you can confirm?
I think it is very, very clear. We have come out very clearly, officially, as well as in all statements, that we cannot comment on speculations. You see, this has been going on for more than 2 years. You know, at different points of time, initially it came that Etihad is intending to increase the stake. Then when it does not come out truth, then some other stories. So I cannot be commenting on the speculation and the rumors which are floating around. We know that our focus is to work on the performance of the company, which has been demonstrated in the last two and a half years. We have demonstrated 9 straight consecutive quarters of profitability and debt reduction, which are the two significant parameters on an operating and a financial performance to show that how the company is moving forward. Also, if you look at the capacity increase that we have done between 2013 to now, close to from a 40 billion ASK on a run rate basis, we have moved to a 53 billion ASK. And this year, as we have gone out public, that we are taking 8 aircrafts in this year to increase further the capacity. And got all our 777s back from Etihad and started to operate into the fleet.
Amit, you also said that you're expecting a revenue growth of about 9 to 10%. But since crude prices have once again started moving higher, how much would your margins be impacted?
No, look at it. If you see, when your volume of activity goes up, the absolute number, obviously, on each of these line items which you mentioned would go up. But what is pertinent to know is about CASK excluding fuel. So give you a perspective, 2 years back, our CASK excluding fuel was 3 rupees 33 paisa. And if I consider the inflation as well as the depreciation on the currency rupee, because most of these expense line items are connected with linked with dollar, it should have landed by now to the level of 390. Whereas we have been able to bring it down and demonstrate it to the level below 320. That shows clearly that our cost reduction efforts and utilization has worked well in favor of the company and has been demonstrated to reduce the cost of operations and delivered profitability over the last 9 quarters.
Okay, but you're still not ready to say that you can sustain EBITDA margins above 15%.
So, as I said, I am not going to give a guidance, and therefore I talk about what has been demonstrated, and one should take comfort from what has been a demonstrable performance, and it is not just a quarter or 2 quarters, it is over 9 quarters.
No, I take your point about your 9-quarter margin performance. Any fundraising exercise that we should expect?
Okay, if you look at it, fundraising, obviously the company evaluates various opportunities in order to optimize or may reduce the cost of borrowing, and thereby we will not rule out a possibility to say one or the other opportunity would exist in order to reduce the cost of borrowing and would do some kind of a refinancing.